Hello. If you have had a penile fracture or if you are suspecting a penile fracture, it is a medical emergency. I urge you to stop watching this video and directly proceed to a medical emergency room for urgent management. If you are in New Delhi, India and you wish to receive emergency treatment with me, then you can contact the given numbers below and proceed. If you are stable, I will in this video tell you the emergency steps to take to stabilize yourself and then to move to an emergency. After that, I will discuss with you why a penile fracture has happened, what are the treatment options for this condition, and why penile fracture is not such a dangerous thing as it looks. Hello, I hope that you are in the emergency room and you are seeing this video. A penile fracture basically means that your penis during erection has had a trauma, and because of which the tunica albuginea or the white structural layer in your penis has developed a crack. Why does penile fracture happen? A penile fracture happens because during extensive or due to a very excessive sexual episode, due to the strain, the protective or the covering that provides the hardness to the penis has popped. And because it has popped, there is loss of blood from the penis. The erection goes down and the blood collects around the penis, giving rise to something called as a Bangun swelling or something called as a eggplant deformity. So what that basically means is that there's an erect penis full of blood. On the erect penis, there is a covering called as tunica albuginea, which is basically a very stiff, hard covering, which gives the penis the good erection it deserves. During very hard sex, sometimes this covering will break, very, very rarely. When this covering breaks, the patient hears a pop sound, the erection suddenly goes away, and there is a lot of pain, and the entire blood in the penis will collect around the penis, giving rise to an eggplant deformity, which looks like this. Now, if you have had such an episode, or if you're experiencing this, the first thing for you is to calm down. The more you will be agitated, the more they'll be bleeding. So the first step that you need to take is to calm down. Relax. It is a fracture. It will be repaired. It will get okay. It is not the end of the world. Second thing is that you will not have pain immediately, because right now you are in an arousal state. So you need to take a painkiller, whichever is available with you. A crocin or a Voveron or a Combiflam or a oxycodone, whichever is, take it right now, because before the pain sets in, the pain will be controlled. Third, calm down your partner. Your partner may also be freaking out with you. So instead of freaking out, just calm down. Third, call an emergency or try to visit an emergency. Most doctors are sympathetic towards penile fracture. They will not judge you and they will give you the correct treatment that you deserve. If you leave a penile fracture untreated, you will end up with lifelong erectile dysfunction. So please visit a doctor right now. Fourth, if you have some ice available in your hotel or in your house, please take the ice and put a lot of ice compresses on the penis, because this ice will stop the bleeding, give you pain relief and reduce the swelling and prevent it from getting bigger. If you have taken these emergency steps at home, it is now time for you to proceed to an emergency. In the emergency, your doctors will stabilize you, will start an IV drip, give you some antibiotics, and you will require surgery. A penile fracture is a surgical emergency, and it is very important that the crack in the tunica or the sheath is repaired, because it will prevent development of peronies, curvature, cordy and long-term erectile dysfunction. So the correction is done by two methods. If the swelling is too much and a lot of blood is collected around the penis, then a circumcision incision is given and the entire foreskin is degloved, or the entire penis skin is degloved. After the degloving of the penis, all the blood clot that has collected inside is washed and removed. After that, the fractured part is identified and there are two sutures that are done to repair it. After repairing, an artificial erection will be produced to check there is no curvature and no bending. And after that, after cleaning up the entire thing, the skin will be put back again and stitched together. You will have a bandage. This fractures and the bandage will usually heal in 10 to 12 days. And in 21 days to a month, you shall be able to have intercourse again. You shall be normal again. You should be able to attend your work and your home duties from the next day onwards. You do not require admission for more than 24 hours in cases of penile fracture. So penile fracture treatment is easy. If the swelling is not too much, then there is something called as the minimally invasive penile fracture treatment, in which instead of removing the entire skin, the fracture site is felt A very small incision is made directly over the fracture site. The fracture area is exposed and repaired. The area is irrigated and closed, and with such a small incision, the patient can actually be discharged within 2 to 3 hours instead of even staying for a day. So if you have had a penile fracture, the treatment is easy. I outlined the emergency steps. Calm down, take your painkillers, put some ice pack, calm down your partner, get dressed and visit an emergency room. If you are in New Delhi, India, and you wish to receive treatment with me, you can always come to the given numbers. We will admit you, start your IV drips, produce and do an emergency surgery for you and stabilize your fracture, and you should be ready for your next happy sexual episode within 15 days. There are some conditions which may masquerade as penile fracture. They are not penile fracture, but they may look. One of the most common condition is something called as venous bleed. There are a lot of veins in the penis. Sometimes these veins may explode, look like a pop, produce the same amount of swelling, but there is actually no fracture. In these conditions, treatment is conservative, no surgery is required. So I hope that I tried to solve your penile fracture doubts in as easy as possible. I hope you get fine early and get back to your life as soon as possible. Thank you for listening to me. Please subscribe to my channel for regular updates and information about andrological problems. Thank you so much.